This is definitely not enough beef to make my breakfast. Shout out past Nick.
One thing that greatly challenges my indomitable human spirit is when you finally gather up enough willpower to get out of bed and go cook that first bulking meal, or any meal, and you get there and you don't have the shit you need to make that meal. I feel like the worst version of that is when you make your meal and then you get to the end of it, you're missing like an end time ingredient, but you don't realize to the end. So it's like with my pasta and beef, it's like maybe I'm missing pasta sauce and now I either get dry lean beef and pasta, which is already dry enough, or I can go to the store and get pasta sauce and get cold ass beef and pasta. Finally had some squats on the channel last night. Sorry, it wasn't that exciting. Kind of just like working our way back into it. I'm thinking, so I was doing the belt list. I'm thinking that when it comes to squats, you know, my mobility already isn't great, and using the Inzer belt, which is a 13 millimeter belt, that's a basketball one. It's a 13 millimeter belt, so it's extra stiff. And so it kind of limits my mobility more than I needed to on squats. So I'm thinking I might have to switch back to a 10 millimeter belt when it comes to squats. So that's why I was doing them beltless. Yeah, but yeah, they felt decent. You know, it wasn't anything exciting, just 315 and 275. An Inzer belt is great. I just think for me, for my circumstances in particular, it's not the optimal setup to get the most out of the squat. I think it might be part of the reason they're so uncomfortable for me. I don't know. I'm just experimenting, trying to find out what works best. Could just be like, I need to work on my mobility personally. Might not be the belt at all. I don't know. I've got some weird ass leverages for squats. That's why I know I'm not the best at them and I don't post them, but I can get good at squats. I just shouldn't get them down properly. If you got stuck at being hydrated, just get like a half gallon jug, like one of these. Take it everywhere you go, slam two or three these day, and make it so easy. Because you can just sip on it whenever you're doing nothing. Like right now.
Walmart parking lot. Walmart parking lot.
Sunny day.
potatoes, beef, chicken.
I've been buying that same shit chicken from Walmart for years. This is the first time I've noticed the price increase.
Yeah.
If you've watched a lot of my videos, you know about the hook grip thumbnail. So if you get a longer thumbnail, hook grip is like a way to grip the bar on deadlifts. It's why I can do double overhand for such heavy weight. It's a little painful, but having a longer thumbnail gives you more surface area to grip. It can give you, it's an advantage when it comes to hook grip. It'll benefit you.
Pasta sauce.
Pasta. It's just funny because like whenever I record certain things, I'll try to like hide my thumbnail.
Bagels.
And it's not like I'm insecure about them. It's just I don't want like a new person who's never watched my videos to come across my channel and be like, wow, fuck this dude and his ugly ass thumbnails. When it comes to buying shit like shampoo and conditioner, ideally I'd want something that's like the right one for my hair, but I have no idea what that would be. So in the meantime, we just get some endocrine system disrupting chemical balm. And maybe in the future, we get one of those natural, good for your hair ones that grows on trees.
Legal trenbolone acetate.
I'm not actually getting that shit. I feel like pasta really isn't the most high quality carb source you can have, but it's so easy to get down and so convenient that it's always kind of been a staple in my diet. Maybe I'll filter out one day.
Rice crispies.
I think that's all I need. I think. Shout out Code Nick. All right, let's go home. All right, so I don't really have anything else to do today. I'm probably just gonna spend the day editing this video, eating my meals. Lately, I've been watching Better Call Saul. I don't usually make time to watch a TV show, but this one's really fucking good. If you guys haven't watched it, you should check it out. If you like Breaking Bad, like, you'll definitely like this show. I like it a lot. But yeah, I'm gonna do all that shit and then I'll probably see you guys when we go to the gym. Also, I don't think I said this yet. If you guys fuck with the vid, maybe drop a like, subscribe. I'll wait. All right, thanks. All right, guys, it's time to go to the gym. Yo, look at this fucking ad I got on TikTok. Actually, my screen's all fucked up. I'll throw it up on the screen. Quick side story of why my screen's fucked up. So when I fly the drone, I have to take it out of the phone case. And I ended up having my phone out of the phone case for literally one day because I just like put my phone case in my camera bag or some shit. And that one day was the day my phone decided to slip out of my pocket and take that fatal fall that railed the whole screen. Look at this ad. I'll throw up a few screenshots. How does this pass the TikTok ad review system? You know, I'm pretty sure they have a person look at them. It's funny, but it's like, it's generally supposed to be like a kid's app. I don't know, I thought that was funny shit. But yeah, we're just in deads today. I got a scoop of Rise Blackout. That's what I rock for deads lately. I'm gonna drink that. We're gonna drive to the gym. I'll see you guys there. Made it back to the gym again. I'm cooking up another deadlift session for you guys. I'm honestly not expecting anything special from this deadlift session. Like I've talked about before, the deadlift session that follows like my hamstring, glute, posterior chain focused leg day, it's usually pretty weak in comparison to the one that follows my quad focused leg day. And my hamstrings are feeling sore as shit today. So hopefully the session will be all right, but I'm not expecting anything special. Yo, real quick, pro tip with your shoes. If you get a shoe that's like half a size too small for you, like these are for me, if you take the insoles out of them, you can sometimes get them to fit just right if they're just like just a bit too small, crushing your toes. I did that with these shoes and they fit like perfect for me. But yeah, try it out. Anyways, we're gonna get into this deadlift session. Hopefully it isn't too shit. One thing I need to work on is holding the camera steady while I vlog. I know some people were commenting about how a little shaky when I'm vlogging. So, but yeah, we're gonna get into this deadlift session. Hopefully it's decent. right, so that 585 kind of moved like shit. The 545 before that was like perfect, but when I get to heavier weights, I have this problem where I kind of just focus on getting hyped for it, and my technique is shit. Like, if you watch it back, I kind of have this hiccup at the top with the lockout, which is an old problem I had, and I fixed it. Now I'm doing it again. I think it's just like habit, but it's whatever. Not every session is gonna be great. I'm dropping the weight down to 565, and I'm gonna do a bunch of sets of two. See how those go. Hopefully it isn't too bad. We'll see. All right, so that last set moved like shit. I keep seeing that my hips are rising before the bar leaves the ground, which is like a loss of power. It's just not the best. I think I'm overthinking my technique way too much. Like every set, I'm like way over analyzing it. And I watched this video from Joey Flex. He's like a powerlifting coach, super knowledgeable guy. But basically what he talked about is how maybe you're just too fatigued and you need a deload and your technique isn't bad. And it's that fatigue that's having you to have bad technique for your reps to fuck up, stuff like that. So I'm thinking maybe I just need a deload. It's just hard because deloading is boring and sucks, but it's what you gotta do. Also, it could just be that my hamstrings are sore as shit from the leg day. You know, I'm probably just overthinking it way too much, which happens a lot. Don't let that get to you. Like, don't let one bad session overthink. Like, oh man, my technique is shit. Why doesn't it look like this? Why doesn't it look like it did before? I don't know. I did it a lot. But yeah, that's all we have for deads today. Wasn't the best session, but that was kind of expected given the circumstances. One of these days, I'm gonna have a coach. We're gonna dial it in. I'm gonna blow up this deadlift. For now, I'm doing it solo style. It's not the most effective way. But yeah, we're gonna get into the hypertrophy side of the workout. Try to get jacked. Well, maybe, hopefully. I'll see you after. Guys, that's gonna be a wrap for the session. I just found a hoodie that I left here. So one thing I wanted to talk about a bit more was the overthinking part. When it comes to lifting, you could be at your top strength and not even know it. You know, you may not be able to hit those top numbers, but you could still be at your best. There's just so many variables that play into it. It's really easy to get in your head with it when you're just not your strongest. You know, today with my session, I was honestly just overthinking my technique so much. I was switching up every set. And is that really gonna benefit me, or should I just stick to what I was doing? It could just be as simple as I need to deload, or I need to get more sleep, or I should be upping my calories. You know, my recovery just isn't there. And you'll overthink it into a million different things. Even though you might be at your best, it's just the circumstances regarding it that are stopping you from lifting that kind of weight, or lifting the most amount of weight you can. And it's so easy for people to say, like, oh, I just don't overthink it. Like, wow, that really helped my situation. You just kind of got to look at it from an outside perspective and really see what's going on. Think of the variables. And that goes with anything, you know, when it comes to overthinking. Like, I remember when I would post on TikTok and I was really trying to grow on there, like, sometimes I'd go a week, which feels like a long time, because back then I was posting like maybe 2 or 3 times a day. So that could be like 20 posts or some shit that I had to think of, put together, and put out. And none of them would hit. And then the next week I pop off and I do great. But it's like during that week, it's like, damn, did I really fucking fall off already? Am I irrelevant because of this 1 week? Probably not. You got to look at it from the outside. It's like, well, I'm still the most followers I've ever had. You know, I'm the farthest I've ever been with this. So is it really that bad? Probably not. When it comes to overthinking, I think the biggest thing you can do is just look at things objectively, you know, kind of look at it from an outside perspective, look at the variables. You know, is it really that bad? Probably not. You know, most of the situations we're put in aren't as bad as we overthink them in our head to be. But yeah, overall, it was a mid session, but you know, we're not going to overthink it, because I probably just need a deload and my hamstrings are sore as shit. So that's probably why my deadlifts were ass. But yeah, I'll catch you guys at home. So we have to end the video off inside again. I'm pretty sure my upstairs neighbor, when they leave for work, whatever they do, they just open the balcony so their dog can be a menace to society while they're at work. I would bark back at them, you know, show them what's good, but I live here and it's like 5 a.m, so I can't really do that. Also, I'm really gonna try my best to have an upload schedule, so every Tuesday and Saturday, stay tuned for a video. Maybe. I'm gonna try my best. But yeah, Tuesdays and Saturdays, that's when I want to upload. We're probably going to get a time on it, but I'm not there yet. Was going to take those stims for the deadlift session that I showed you guys in the last video, but I knew I was going to kind of have a mid session. So I'm going to save those for when we can have a great session, you know, put them together and hopefully make something happen. But yeah, I appreciate you guys watching the video. If you guys made it this far, make sure you guys drop a like and subscribe. One thing that sucks about YouTube is the majority of people don't watch the whole video, which is with anything. Like on TikTok, you post a 30-second video, your average watch time is like maybe 10 seconds, maybe 15 seconds. Yeah, shout out to the real ones who made it through the whole video. Because like sometimes I have the best parts within the last 5 minutes. It's like, damn, most people miss that. That fucking sucks. But yeah, I appreciate you guys watching the video. This jug did drop today from Young LA, as well as some other stuff. Yeah, code Nick on Rise in Young LA. I'm going to eat my food, try to get some sleep, and I'll catch you guys next time.